So tonight I'm going to talk about acid and alkaline, and how come certain will look at being a vegan or being vegetarian, how come we have different health, to call it the health race, you know, we're racing at a different speed, even though you can say, hey, I'm a vegan, and the listener always says, hey, I'm a vegetarian, we are racing at different speeds, even as, let's say we're all vegans, we're still at different speeds, based upon acids and alkaline. Okay, now when we talk about acids and alkaline, that's the food represented, you know, some are more alkaline-based and others are more acid-based. Now, I have this list, it's an ancient old list that I printed out years and years ago, but this has to do with, like last night I made some beans, and I'm like, well, yeah, we know, they have issues with our system. Beans are actually acid-based, okay? So if you look at a lot of the pulses, those types of things are acid-based. So they're not actually an ease to us. Okay, now we have, I look at our saliva, our saliva is alkaline saliva, okay? Whereas a tiger is acid saliva, okay? So you have, we'll do the variation here of a tiger and the human, okay? And monkey also. We're talking the acid saliva versus the alkaline. So right away, the digestion process is beginning or not beginning. Okay, so let's say you're ingesting acids. Okay, you're taking, oh my gosh, I don't want to say it, but spaghetti is on the acid side. Okay, I'm so sorry. But you're taking in spaghetti. And because you're taking in spaghetti, now your alkaline saliva is like not helping. Okay, so the already down, it's going down your gullet, it's not helping. You have a non-helper. Alright, whereas on the other side of the block here, what do I have? I have dandelion roots listed. No, I have a lot of things. Chili peppers and peaches. Of course, all of the fruits are alkaline. We do have a few that are not. Most of all the vegetables are alkaline. So everything is great over there as long as you're eating the vegetables and the fruits. But when you switch over into the acid side and you start eating like a pasta, you are eating acids. And so your system is not the tiger, because remember the tiger has the shorter digestion, he has the shorter area where meat sits. You know, meat sits in his intestines less time. You know, he just has a shorter tract. Whereas you put an acid meat in our system, we do have some acid in our intestinal tract, but it has to move that meat, so far. It has to keep going and go, keep going and keep going and keep going. So you can understand why people get tired out, sluggish systems. It's because it has to keep going through all of that. Okay, and putrefactions and all of this buildup and then toxin release. Because, hey, you know, a tiger, he got through with it. You know, maybe it took him, it's just his acid direction at that meat is completely different from our direction because we're an alkaline direction from the very beginning. Okay. I hate to say it, but beans and rice are both listed on the acid side. Okay. And yuck. I mean, what are we going to do? Even almond milk is listed on the acid side. Okay. Some of our favorite nuts are on the acid side. Okay. We have peanuts on the acid side. And a lot of you eat peanut butter. That's acidic. That's like just a human being a tiger again. Okay. So we have the peanut butter. We have the tahini. We have the walnuts. All listed on the acidic side. Whereas there, oh my gosh, do I have my nut roll here at the ready? Are there any nuts available for us on the other side? I would hope so. I'm going to have to look that one up, because this is really important. It's really important, I think. You know, we're talking about the cure, trying to get rid of diseases, trying to take, you know, diseases are just things that claim your body, you know, so you want them to unclaim. You know, say, hey, stop. Stop doing that. Stop taking a portion of me and hurting me, you know. And you can really, you know, when you look at acids and you know what acids do and you've seen the movies and they dip their bodies in the hydrochloric acid or whatever, and everybody's like, ooh, you know, this type of thing is like, well, our bodies are not that, you know, we're not capable of that type of a build, you know, to get rid of. Whereas a tiger can, he has that action. And wolves, they have that action. They are meat eaters, you know what I'm saying, meat eaters. Except for a few flowers. I have seen certain animals, the wolf variety, they will take a top off a flower occasionally. But that's unusual. That's just like our opposite, you know, like, you know how, it's just like when you're eating, you know, in the old days and evolution time was going around, let's say you ate some fruit or whatever and there was an insect there. That's the contretemps. That's the little opposite. And it's a small amount, that little insect with the fruit and the vegetable. Whereas the small amount with the carnivore animal, he has, what does he have? He has maybe some flour there, maybe some grasses, a small amount. So he has the opposite. You know, we might have a few insects thrown in, and he might have a few grasses and flowers. So we're just complete and total opposites, and yet our structured society, our fast food restaurants, all the restaurants you go to, they are formulated around the acids. They have the Italian restaurants. You're going and you're going to eat a bunch of acids. And I'm not saying the tomato is the acid at all here. I'm saying it's the pastas. Okay. So, where am I? Corn is a terrible acid also. So we have the corn over there. So this is really sad for when you think about the southern border diet, where they have indigenous, they have the corn, they have the beans, and they have the rice. Not a longev. It's just not a longev for your body. So it's very interesting. We really need to pay attention to the conflict, you know, because I believe the conflict, you're feeding the acids in, you say you're vegan, but I just only love to eat the acid foods and be a vegan. I don't think you're going to have the same success rates as the vegan that is taking the alkaline diet in as his or her main primary foods, okay? I believe you can throw in a few acids occasionally, but they cannot be your primary foods. You know what I'm saying? So, this is for me who ate corn tortillas today. Now I'm reading this and going, oh my gosh, I'm not supposed to do this. Okay. Now, obviously certain things on the acid side, like the cheese and the milk and the butter, they're all on the acid side. Okay. But, So that's not good for vegetarians. You know, vegetarians are taking in a bunch of acids by doing this. We have the, where do I have else? Now, cranberries, there is a fruit that went to the acid side. The cranberries, the tart little cranberry. They jumped the fence. Okay, so let's not be, it can't be all fruits, it's just these cranberries jump the other side. Now oils are the acids. Okay, so we have, and these are whether cooked or raw, they're still the acidics. So the sunflower, the sesame, the safflower, the olive, the lard, the flax, and the hemp seed. I'm sorry, they're listed as acids. Okay, then we have what else? We have distilled vinegars are in your acids. You have wheat germ, you have potatoes. Okay, so there is a staple that is in diets all over the world, these potatoes. Now, they're not listed as an alkaline vegetable. They're listed as an acid vegetable. So, shock of shocks. So that one does not make it. So when we're thinking of really heavy carbs, spaghettis and potatoes, I'm not saying feed that to a tiger though, am I? Because he's really carnivore and he's really on the meat list. There he goes with all the meats and the fish. So the meat and the fish and the fowl, all of that are on the acid side. So where was I? Drugs, any drugs are on the acid side, unless, even here it says psychedelic, but then on the other side it says mushrooms are alkaline. So it's very possible that if it's a psychedelic mushroom, you're not an acid, but it's an interesting list. And then I have alcohol. All your alcohols, your spirits, your hard liquors, your wines, there they go. Alright, they're on the acid. Okay, and then this is a very important list. This is your green, your beans, your black beans, your chickpeas, your green peas, your kidney beans, your lentils, your lima beans, your pintos, your red, your soys, your white beans, your rice milk, and your almond milk, all acidic. Now, when I looked at the grains are not helping either. Most of the grains are acidics. We have, in the nut family, we have almonds over there. If you just have a handful of almonds, they're alkaline. But as soon as you turn them into milk, they become acidic. So we have in the grains that are all acid grains, unfortunately. we have flour, hemp seed, wheats, kamuts, spelts, rye, rice, all rices, the quinoa, the oats, rolled oats, buckwheats, barleys, amaranth, wheat cakes, and rice cakes, all of them being acidic. Okay. So yuck. Unfortunately, we use those a lot, don't we, to just like bolster the food, because we get tired of only eating vegetables and fruit sometimes, but it doesn't look like that's the way to go. Like if you're really trying to battle something, you really need to be like, well, how am I going to get my proteins? Well, on the protein side of the alkalines, almonds are listed, tofu is listed, chestnuts, there you go, chestnut dropped across, and flax seeds, pumpkin seeds, the tempeh that's been fermented, squash seeds, sunflower seeds, millet, sprouted millet, any sprouted seeds, and then nuts. Yeah, so if you're, when it says nuts, that's confusing because there were the other nuts on the other side. So I think I would take that one away. But maybe sprouted seeds or sprouted nuts, that's what they were trying to say. This is actually information from the Wolfe Clinic from a long time ago. Like I said, it's an acid alkaline list. So here we are. So not all nightshades though are acidic. I believe, let's find, what is that great eggplant? The great eggplant makes it to the alkaline list. So if you're eating a lot of potatoes, maybe you switch to like eggplants, or what's another one? Do we have sweet potatoes on this list? Gosh darn it, I don't see sweet potatoes. I'm going to have to find out about those. But this is where we're at. And I wanted to call it this video War and Peace, because in a way, if you eat the acid diet, the acidic diet, you know, more if most of your food is revolving around the acids, it looks like you're a war character. You know, you are a character of, and this is why you can't say all vegans are passive, or all vegans are aggressive, or vice versa. Is because it depends, it's depending on the acid intake or the alkaline intake of each. You know, if you're eating a bag of corn chips and then you're having pasta and then you're having you know, a handful of nuts, walnuts, that's a total acid day. You know what I mean? Anyway, so we're talking about war and peace. Now, when I say peace, I mean Brontosaurus. Brontosaurus was peace. And I say war, I say T-Rex. Okay, he was war. Those two vast disparities in diet from the very beginning on this planet. We're looking at a total alkaline-based diet from that Brontosaurus and an acid-based diet off the T-Rex. Okay, so Brontosauruses were pretty calm. They're just like giraffes, you know, they're grazers. So is it true, you know? Is the war of yourself, does it really live in that acid intake? You know, how much you're ingesting? And the peace of yourself, you know, how much peace are you? How much peace are you capable of being? And when you switch to total fruits and vegetables, are you just going to be, you know, the peace monkey? You know. Anyway, yeah, I know there is the aggressive violent. I believe it's the chimpanzee is one of the most violent of the apes, but. It's possible that they are ingesting something acidic also, extra, something extra that is ramping them up into war. They get war-y, you know, they start to war and fight. So it's really something to maybe correlate right away. Acid, alkaline, war and peace. That's it. Okay guys, that's it. That's for tonight.